The Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1882, Vlookup into Subtotal Data. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Another question from the Fort Wayne Seminar. So we have data here that has been subtotaled, right? Using data subtotals at each change in customer, add subtotals here. And then we have another sheet with a list of customers, and we have to Vlookup from this sheet back into the other sheet. Let's see if we can get these side by side. New window, view, arrange all, vertical. Yep. And then we can see what the data looks like, and two methods. All right, so my first method, as I'm thinking about this, you have AIG and the words AIG total, is not to use a VLOOKUP at all. We can actually use equals SUMIFS, and the sum range is over here in column F, comma, and then we want to look through column D to see if it is equal to this customer here. And by using SUMIFS, we will get the right answer all the way down. So my first inclination was not to do a VLOOKUP at all. But if we really want to do a VLOOKUP, then equal VLOOKUP of this customer concatenated with a space and the word total into, let's say, columns D, E, and F, comma, 3, comma, false, and we get the same answers. All right. Someone said, well, hey, why didn't you just collapse this down to the number 2 view and select visible cells and copy? Well, you know, because in real life, sometimes, you know, we have to populate data into a report that's already there, and, you know, lots of reasons. So a couple of different ways to go here to get a VLOOKUP into subtotal data. The first one is not to use VLOOKUP at all, just to use SUMIFS and count on the fact that the subtotal rows have the word total. The other one, to actually concatenate the space total after the customer name, and that will grab the totals from the subtotal rows. Two very different ways to go. I thought that was a great question coming out of the Power Excel seminar in Fort Wayne. I'll be in Tampa, Florida next week, May 9th, for another Power Excel seminar. Hopefully we'll get lots more good tips and questions coming out of that seminar, which, of course, will make it to the podcast in case you can't be there. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast with MrExcel.com.